the debate over software patents. Can you patent computer software? The boundary between ideas and applications might seem clear, but it became blurred with the advent of computer technology 40 years ago, especially regarding the patentability of software. The courts have tried repeatedly to clarify the limits of patentability in the computer age. Three Supreme Court cases in particular reveal the evolution of its thinking about software patentability. These cases are often called the Patent Eligibility Trilogy. In 1927, Gottschalk v. Benson, the Supreme Court held that an algorithm in a computer program was in and of itself not patentable. In this case, a mathematical procedure executed electronically was too similar to long division with paper and pencil. The court saw such a patent as analogous to granting a patent on a natural phenomenon or mental process. Delivering the court's opinion, Justice William Douglas explained that the patent would wholly preempt the mathematical formula and in practical effect would be a patent on the algorithm itself. The court made a point of saying, however, that its decision did not mean that computer software could not be patented, only that software whose only useful characteristic was an abstract algorithm could not be patented. The Supreme Court further refined its thinking on software patentability in the 1978 case, Parker v. Fluke, the second case in the trilogy. Unlike the attempt to patent all uses of an algorithm, the software in question was limited to a specific application, triggering an alarm during the catalytic chemical conversion of hydrocarbons. This was a specific and tangible use of an algorithm, but the court still ruled the software unpatentable because it felt the application itself was not inventive. But, once again, the court left the door open by stating that, even though a phenomenon of nature or mathematical formula may be well known, an inventive application may be patented. Lastly, in the 1981 case of Diamond v. Dyer, the Supreme Court made its third attempt to define the patent eligibility of software. The court ultimately ruled that although algorithms by themselves are not patentable, a software program that used algorithms to govern the molding of raw synthetic rubber into cured precision products was in fact patentable because it involved transforming or reducing an article to a different state or thing. These three rulings appeared to define clear limits for software patentability. That although algorithms by themselves are abstract concepts and therefore unpatentable, software programs may be patented if they employ algorithms to produce a tangible and inventive or transformative result. This view was further augmented by a 1998 decision by the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Federal Circuit in State Street Bank v. Signature Financial Group, which extended software patentability to software-enabled methods of doing business so long as these produced a useful, concrete, and tangible result. But this was not to last. The same court rejected the useful, concrete, and tangible result test just 10 years later in R.E. Bilski, which upheld the USPTO's denial of a patent for a method of hedging risk in commodities trading. The court instead offered a machine or transformation test, which allows a software program or business method to be patented only if it is implemented on a specific machine to achieve a special purpose that is novel, non-obvious, and useful, or if it transforms an article from one thing or state to another. But in its review of Bilski v. Kappos, the Supreme Court ruled that while the machine or transformation test was useful, it was not the only test for patentability. They also reaffirmed that business methods may indeed be patentable. Then in June of 2014, the Supreme Court issued what may be its most consequential decision on the patentability of software in the 33 years since Diamond v. Dyer. In Alice v. CLS Bank, the court ruled that taking some activity that people have been doing for centuries, in this case, holding funds in escrow until a transaction is completed, and then merely doing it through a computer, did not turn this age-old activity into a patentable new invention. It soon became clear that district courts were using the Alice v. CLS Bank decision to invalidate a relatively large number of software patents. This trend has become known as the Alice paradox. As these often involve the highest value-added products and services involving cloud computing, big data, and other new technologies, this is posing a challenge for many corporate innovation departments. To be patentable nowadays, software has to take a genuinely inventive step and either trigger an action, employ a device, or otherwise produce a tangible, transformative result.